And with that, we come to the end, to the conclusion of this relatively short album.
Where MC's going to give his score out of 10.
No, never. Never again am I doing that. But
pretty
I will say that...
3 times 2 is 6. That's it.
6 out of 10. That's it, guys. We came to the end of this record, the first and only Vanity 6 album project. And, I'm spent. Someone say something. I'm
say,
spent.
It is a bit of a shame that the Apollonia 6 album was such an obvious, like, you know, the Purple Rain, the movie was in production, Vanity's in it. It's going to be another Vanity 6 album. And then there's obviously some conflict between Vanity and Prince over who knows what, really. And then the next thing you know, it's Apollonia 6. And it's such a shame that it always seemed kind of obviously contrived, the Apollonia thing. And obviously that's nothing against Apollonia, the person. It's not her fault. But it's kind of a shame that she didn't just stick around for Purple Rain era.
Yeah.
She kind of missed out.
She missed out on that Purple Rain money. Oh, well.
That was it. Conclusions, guys. So at the end of this album review session, what is everyone's thoughts? How are you guys treating this album?
I think this album still stands as a good once every few years listen. Maybe every 2 or 3 years, just listen to it once. That's good. But I'll tell you, when I was writing my notes, when I was listening to it for the review, I can't remember which song it was. It might have been the one where I heard, you know, there's some song, we think it's Prince, you hear him doing some backing vocals, and it just hit me. They're both not here anymore. And that was just a weird moment. Because I think it was in like this, you know, this poppy song. And then that just like sadness thing just goes bang. And I'm like, oh, yeah. But anyway, someone else talk because we can't end the show on that.
Well, I wasn't thinking of that until you said it. But yeah, it is kind of obvious now that you mentioned it. Yeah. Someone else say something positive.
Well, again, not forgetting the other two, who, which I just did. Susan and Brenda. Yay. They're still here.
God, this is the worst ending ever.
I'll just say, you know, it's fun for what it is. It's not flawless. It could have been a lot better, I guess. It's a shame that, like, none of the songs really compare to the first track. For me, I could probably scrap the last two tracks. I pretty rarely listen to those last two tracks and have it more like a Vanity EP kind of thing. Or even like a, you know, a best of this and the Apollonia one would make a half-decent album. But as it stands, it's hard to score it more than like a 5, really. 5 and a bit, maybe.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about a score. Oh, let me think. Play it.
My overall thoughts is I always saw these songs as Prince singing from a female perspective. I think up until this time, you know, he was dancing that line of androgyny and, you know, he was a male artist, but he had this kind of female vibe about him. And if he sang these songs himself, I don't know how that would have gone down for him. So, you know, he's used these songs as an outlet, as specifically for a girls group. And clearly Nasty Girl is the strongest track. And then, you know, other songs are sort of being drafted in to fill it out. It's a great project. It's a shame that it didn't sort of go further and evolve and all that sort of stuff. But you know, it's a great sort of early 80s funk album. I would rate it maybe 5 or 6, because purely it's really the strength of the first track. And then you've got all the other kind of songs that go along with it.
I'm going to say 5.5. I'm in the middle there.
I was just going to add that the concept of Prince writing songs from a female point of view is something that he continued to do for the rest of his career as well. Like Bria Valente album is that, a lot of the Andy Arlo album is that, you know, even potentially some of the, what's her name? The last girl that released the album.
Judith Hill.
Judith Hill. The Tamar and the Judith Hill thing. Like it's something he continued to do throughout the rest of his career. It's interesting.
Well, Carmen, Maite, Jill Jones. I mean, even some of Sheila's stuff. Potentially, so. Yeah, the only comment, the extra comment that I really would make is that, and it goes back to what I said really early on before we started talking about the songs themselves, is in the context of everything else that he was releasing around this time, even though this came out first, prior to the Second Time album and Prince's 1999, it is pretty solid, relatively solid album, if that makes sense, considering everything that happened just before and just afterwards. So, you know, obviously it was a reasonable or a modest success based predominantly on the single, as you guys have all said. But it is, there's enough here to, as Captain said, come back every couple of years and have a bit of fun with it. This is by no means his best Vanity project. And I'm using that word as a pun because obviously there was only one Vanity album or Vanity 6 album. You know, he really solidified himself in writing for other artists and associated artists, you know, 2 or 3, 4 years after this point. So for a first attempt, pretty good.
But then again, it was just Vanity, like copying Prince's Guide track, you would imagine, right?
Mm.
Let's not forget that Prince is only 24 at this point. It's pretty crazy.
Yeah, he would have just turned 24 a few months before this came out, eh? Craziness.
It's crazy when you think he's done this project, The Times' second album, and 1999 double album. Yeah.
The age of 23, 24. That's crazy.
Plus, probably it was the start of, you know, putting together Purple Rain or whatever. You know, there's a lot going on at this period, so.
Mm. Prolific would be an understatement. Prolific would be an understatement. And with that.
Who does that?
Exactly.
You know, the sad answer to that is now nobody.
Well, now definitely no one. Yeah. Even back then, there was only a handful of artists that were as prolific as him or anywhere, you know, close to being as prolific as him. But now you're right.
I'm sure there's some fancy new guy or girl, but I'm not interested. So don't bother like telling me on Twitter, oh, this guy does it. I don't care. It's over now.
It's all over. It's all over. What a great way to finish the show and the episode review. But no, look, I really don't know what else we could say.
This one's good for Denise.
Yeah, there you go. For Denise Matthews and for the other two ladies, Brenda and Susan, and for Prince, all of whom came together to create this record. So
and
if
Jesse,
you haven't heard
and Des and Terry. Right.
And Jamie Starr.
And Jamie Starr.
Just to finish
all
off.
All credit to Jamie Starr.
A Jamie Starr production. And for anyone that hasn't heard this album, which is, it's fair to say that probably not all Prince fans have heard this. There's just so much material that he's released. So if you haven't, go and check it out. It's worth it. If only for 3 × 2 = 6, it's worth it.
Yeah, I don't know where you'll actually find the album, though. It's nowhere to be found.
Print.
Yeah.
I actually think I've got this one on vinyl as well.
Oh, you can send it over to MC to listen.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I do, actually. This is one of the few.
I didn't know you had a record player.
I don't.
Wait till you hear 3 × 2 = 6 on vinyl. Oh,
well, it makes
wow.
perfect sense that you have the vinyl version.
Maybe 15 or 20 Prince vinyls. Then, like, a lot of them are just stuff that I've found randomly over years. And one of them, I just lucky to find this, I think.
Have you got Rave on vinyl?
No. Has it been released on vinyl?
Whoa. Called the law.
There we go.
Yeah, he's definitely masturbating.
All right, guys, we've been caught. Patriot Park police are outside the front of our house.
We heard you listening to 3 × 2 = 6.
It's a crackdown. It's a crackdown.
It's a crime. It's a crime.
2 × 2 = 4. All four podcast members, we got to go. We definitely got to get out of here, guys. Thanks for listening. It's been another exclusive, non-exclusive, exclusive episode of the Peach and Black podcast for 2017, brought to you by Podbean.
Letter V.
And Durex.
The letter V, yeah.
For this episode.
The letter V.